The Pearl River Water Supply District tried it before, but in 2007 they backed off trying to charge a fee on each boat that is placed on the Ross Barnett Reservoir. The district is trying again.
What we're trying to do is develop a revenue source from people who use the lake that will allow us to then improve the facilities on the lake that they use.
As drawn up now, the fee would be $35 a year for each boat under 26 feet long, $50 a year for boats bigger than that. A three-day pass would cost $10, and they would even charge that at bass fishing tournaments at the reservoir.
Reservoir operators say a boat user would not have the excuse of not being able to find a place to buy a permit. They say they'd have a smartphone app where a person could buy that permit online.
And I think they got shot down because the counties that helped build the reservoir put the money into it.
Dale Joyner and Wilton Harrell don't like the idea one bit.
The Reservoir Commission is trying to make as much money as they can, what the whole trick is about.
Well, you got some people don't use a boat that much.
I agree.
And you throw $35 an hour on them, they're going to go somewhere else.
They contend the reservoir has been open to the public without additional charge since it was first opened, and that shouldn't change now because the district wants more money.
Like I said before, the reservoir was filled.
Buddy Medlin has been out here since before the reservoir was constructed. He says those who use the waterway should help fund the cost of improving it.
I do know they need money to keep the improvements going. It's very vital.
We're the only one that does not charge a fee other than Eagle Lake and Warren County.
The district will schedule public hearings on the new fee idea with a plan of starting the extra charge in January. At the reservoir, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.
John Sigmund says the fee could generate more than $200,000 a year for the water supply district.